Hi guys, so I get so many questions about the education system here in Iceland, so in this video I'm going to be answering all of them. The system of education in Iceland is divided into four levels, and they are preschool, compulsory education, upper secondary education, and then higher education. If you're looking for information about a specific level, then I will have a timestamp on the screen right now, so you can just skip through and click on the information that you want. I gathered all of this information from the actual Icelandic government, and if you want to get even more information, you can go to government.is to find out more. So let's start out with the first level, which is preschool, or as we call it in Iceland, leikskóli. Leikskóli. So, leikskóli is defined as the first level of education in Iceland. Preschools or nurseries can be attended from the age 12 months to 6 years, or 5 years if your birthday is very late in the year. However, it is sometimes quite tricky to get accepted into a preschool if there are a lot of children that are applying. So you kind of have to apply for a preschool really early, even as early as when your child is an infant. Just be sure that you get in. And according to the Icelandic government, preschool education is intended to bridge the gap between caring for children and educating them, which I feel like is very accurate. You can study to become a preschool teacher here in Iceland. You can study at the University of Iceland, for an example. However, there are a lot of people that have not studied to become a preschool teacher but are still working as a preschool teacher. All in all, I feel like the preschool system here in Iceland is delightful, and that's all that I have to say about that. If you want more information, then I will leave some on the screen, but let's go to the next level. So the next level of education in Iceland is called compulsory education, or as we call it, grunnskóli. I had no idea that there was an actual word for this. I have been saying in my videos like middle school or high school, but we don't have high school or middle school in Iceland. Compulsory education, or grunnskóli, is organized in a single structure system, so primarily and lower secondary education take place in the same school. So it is kind of like if you would blend high school and middle school together in one school. So you start grunnskóli at the age of 6, or if you're like me and your birthday is very, very late, you will start at the age of 5, and you will graduate at the age of 16, or like me, at 15. So all in all, it's 10 years with the same people at the same building. But I do know that there are a few schools in Iceland where they switch buildings after the age of 13, I think, but it's not like super common. Compulsory education is mandatory and it is free. So because it's 10 years, we have 10 grades. So at age 6, you're in first grade, 7, you're in second grade, and on and on. So you get the point. When you're at grunnskóli, you learn all of the basics. You learn math, science, natural history, social studies, history, languages such as English and Danish. In some schools in Iceland, children start learning English at first grade, so at the age of 6. But in other schools, they start in second grade or third grade. It's so different. And the same goes with Danish. When I was in school, I started learning English in 5th grade and Danish in 7th grade. And for those of you who are just like, what? Why do you have to learn Danish in school? Basically, it's because Iceland did not get its independence from Denmark until like 1944, and Iceland just has a lot of historic ties with Denmark, and that's basically it. To be honest, most kids hate learning Danish, and I was one of those kids, and I suck at Danish till this day. When you get to 8th grade at the age of 13, things get a bit more serious, and at that point you kind of have to start thinking about your grades. Grade 8 till 10th is something that is called unglingastig, which like roughly translates as teenager stage. The reason why you have to start thinking about your grades at that stage is because when you reach 10th grade, you kind of have to think about which school you're going to apply to. So with that being said, let's go to the next level, which is called upper secondary education, or as we call it in Icelandic, framhaldsskóli. Framhaldsskóli is kind of like high school and college blended together. I don't know how to explain it better than that. Students are usually at the age of 16 until 20 in framhaldsskóli. It generally used to be 4 years, but they changed it back in 2016 and now it's only 3 years. However, not all people finish it in 3 years, and that's all good. There are a lot of people who drop out or need to take a break or just want to have more time because classes can be difficult, and that's completely fine. Like, everyone is so different. For me personally, I finished it in 4 years because it was 4 years when I was in framhaldsskóli. It is like completely fine to start, take 1 year, and then you maybe want to travel or work, then you can go do that, and then you can go back to school and finish it. Like, you can do whatever you want because framhaldsskóli is not mandatory, so you don't have to do it if you don't want to. However, most teenagers and people do want to go to framhaldsskóli and finish it eventually. But like I said, there are also so many people that just go to framhaldsskóli and just finish it, like I did. So in 10th grade, you apply to at least 2 schools, your first choice and your backup choice. And the upper secondary schools are just so different. Some are really hard to get into, some are very easy to get into. For an example, I know that Mentaskólinn í Reykjavík is a school where you have to have really good grades to get into. It's really hard to get into. Also, Verslunarskóli Íslands, that's just a very, very popular school that a lot of people want to get into. And we also just have a lot of different schools for people who have different interests. For an example, we have a school called Fjölbrautaskólinn í Garðabæ where you can actually major in drama and theater if you want to become an actor or an actress, then that's a great starting point. We also have a school called Mentaskólinn í Kópavogi where you can major in cooking and baking. That is actually the school that I went to. However, I did not major in baking or cooking. I majored in social studies and I took a lot of extra classes in literature and history just because that is something that interested me. And I don't know how this is in other countries, like in high schools, but in upper secondary education or framhaldsskóli in Iceland, you can kind of choose what you want to major in and pick out which classes you want to take. So you're very like free, I would say. But of course, there are always some mandatory courses that you have to take. But yeah, it's all like very flexible. Now, let's talk about the fee. The fee differs, but generally I think it's about 40,000 Icelandic kronas, which is $300. However, I do know that other schools can be more expensive or less expensive. I looked up websites and I was trying to find out the fee for every school, but the only fee that I found is the $300 one. So because you're only 16 when you enter framhaldsskóli, there are in a lot of cases the parents that actually pay the fee for the child. It's definitely not like that for everyone, I'm just saying. All in all, framhaldsskóli is awesome, at least for me, and I know a lot of people meet their best friends in framhaldsskóli, and they're basically, it's so much fun. And that's all that I have to say about the upper secondary education in Iceland. So let's go to level 4. So at level 4, we have higher education or háskóli, aka university. So there are, according to my research, 7 universities in Iceland. I only thought there were 5. And first we have the University of Iceland or Háskóli Íslands, which is my university. The University of Iceland is definitely the most popular university. It has around 13,000 students studying there. For those of you who are curious and for those of you who are constantly asking me, I have a bachelor's degree in comparative literature and creative writing. And this fall, I am starting a master's program in creative writing. The University of Iceland offers several study programs that are taught fully in English. I get a lot of questions about that. And are therefore open to international students. So yes, you can come here and study in Iceland without knowing any Icelandic. If you want more information on how to study at the University of Iceland, you can go to english.hi.is and I will have everything on the screen. I get so many questions about how to come here and how to study at the university. So please go to the website. You can find all information on there. You can email the school. So please go on their website. I wish I could tell you all and help all of you, but but I don't have all the information, so please go to their website. Now, studying there is not free, but it's super cheap. The whole year or two semesters is 75,000 kronas, which is around $550. Bear in mind that books can be super expensive. So that's everything I have about the University of Iceland. For all information, please go to their site. Next, we have Reykjavik University, or Háskólinn í Reykjavík, who is the largest private university here in Iceland. Reykjavik University's focus is on science and engineering, computer science, business, and law. It is the second largest university here in Iceland, and it has around 3,500 students. So, because Reykjavik University is a private school, it's a lot more expensive than the University of Iceland, so let's just go over that quickly. So 1 year in Reykjavik University is around 500,000 kronas, or about $3,700, and that is if you're getting a bachelor's degree. However, the master's degree is a little bit more expensive. So for 1 year, you are paying somewhere between 750,000 kronas, which is $5,500, up until 2 million kronas, which is around $15,000. Reykjavik University has an exchange program, and so for more information, you have to go to en.ru.is. So please go on their website if you want to know more. I have no information because I don't go to that school, so please go to our website to find out more. Next, we have the Iceland University of the Arts, or Listaháskóli Íslands. There you can learn design and architecture, performing arts, arts education, fine art, and music. It is really, really hard to get into. And there are so, so talented people that study at Listaháskóli Íslands. If you want more information about that, you can go to lhi.is to find out more information. Please go to the site if you want to know more. Then we also have the University of Akureyri, located in Akureyri, and Bifröst University, which is a small university located in Bifröst. Then we have the Agricultural, I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing that wrong, or University of Iceland, which is an educational and research institution in the field of agriculture and environmental sciences. Lastly, we have Háskólinn á Hólum, or Hólar University. So that is basically all of the information that I have. Maybe I can talk about my experience. Honestly, I don't know a lot about the time that I was in preschool. My compulsory education, or grunnskóli, was not that good. I was heavily bullied because I was overweight, so yeah. However, my upper secondary education, or framhaldsskóli, was an amazing experience for me. It's where I met my two best friends. I loved it. I loved every second of it. Amazing. 10 out of 10. Loved it. Also, the University of Iceland. Basically, the love of my life. If you are curious about my master's program, you can follow me on Instagram. I am probably going to share a bit of my studies. So that is basically all that I have for this video. I really hope that I answered some of your questions about the education system here in Iceland. If you want more information, then you can go to all of the links that I've talked about. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys really, really soon. Okay, bye.